darkness has taken you, Galena and Senua. Galena and Senua.
You are lost. There's nothing you can do. You're dead. You're both dead. Mother and daughter dead in the sea of corpses.
Corpses.
Fight it anymore. Not on my own. Where are you, Mother? I want to be with you.
That night, she gave up on her world to follow in the footsteps of her mother. To go to a place where the darkness couldn't reach her.
Senua. Look at me.
Do you hear them? They're calling for me.
We've lost so many. And I've lost my father. I can't lose you.
You said I have blood on my hands.
I didn't say that. You've done nothing wrong.
Zimba was right. Everyone will suffer.
Zimba is a fake. He is a hateful, bitter liar. He's poison. And his words still haunt you. Who do you trust? Him? Or me? Do you still believe in me, Senua? In us? Come back to me. Please. Don't let this darkness come between us.
Hardest battles are fought in the mind. He gave her the sword with which to fight in more ways than one. And she gave him her word, never to surrender. All she needed was a little help. A little hope.
Thank you.
Into the mountain.
Can you see it?
Shall we tell her where to go?
It's not far. Go on.
Look up.
Just up there. Listen to us.
Sit. Shall we tell her where to go?
Shall we?
Does she know which way to look? Does she know her way into the mountain?
She's a good girl, isn't she?
Look up.
So clever.
Did you miss us?
Oh, she did. She did.
We're back.
She's so glad we're back. Go on.
There's a door.
You can do it.
You can see it.
Come on, Senua.
Go away. I'm not listening.
I will tell you of a great hero named Sigurd, son of Sigmund, no less. Born after his father's death, Sigurd is cared for by the dwarf, Reyn. But Reyn does not love the boy. Instead, he plans to use him for his own ends. You see, Reyn's father possessed a great treasure given to him by the gods. But Reyn's brother, Fafnir, killed his father and took the gold all for himself. Fafnir hid the treasure out on a heath and could not leave it. And from the evil in his heart, he turned into a dark creature. A dragon.
It's watching you. She can feel it.
No.
Don't open the door.
Don't go in. Don't go back.
What's it?
Get back! A great beast guards Helheim. Garm is its name. And it knows you are here, Senua. It can smell your stink. What are you afraid of, Senua? How will you say Dillion if you are too much of a coward to step into the shadow?
They can't stop me.
Then do it. The beast is stalking you from the shadows. Your sword is useless here.
Senua.
It's so loud.
It's not her.
So full of hate.
It's a trap.
I just want to help them. Tell me what to do. Your father wants them to go away. And he only hurts me to silence them. But he's gone now.
But they always come back. He says I will die if I go with them. They say that I'm already dead.
No,
and they want me with them.
Stop!
That's why they crawl through the walls.
Don't listen.
Do you
to them.
See them?
Do you see their faces? He's coming! Senua! Help me! Help! Get me out of here! Don't go!
Where has she gone? She's disappeared again.
She shouldn't be here. She escaped the darkness. She took her own life to escape it.
She can't remember when it started. When her mother lost her smile. Her eyes gazing past her towards a world she could not see. This is what happens if you reach for the underworld, he said. It was a lot to take in for a child. And the first time she felt the cold chill of fear. I don't talk much about her father, Zinbel. I suppose I just didn't want to risk upsetting her. But it doesn't matter now, does it?
She'll have to go.
She has to. She can't.
The light's gone out. Run, run, get through it as quick as you can. The panic is here.
What's that? Fight! Send! I'm winning! without your light. Take the torch and move.
She has it.
She did it. She's done it.
Well done.
This place, it reminds her of the isolating, suffocating darkness that she lived through as a young girl. Imprisoned in her room at night, the faces in the dark, coming through the walls. She once thought everyone could see them. I mean, that's what children say all the time, isn't it? That there are monsters in the dark. By the time she realized that only she could see them, her father, Zinbel, could see the monster in her.
Thank you.
it's not. It's gonna run out soon.
She hasn't got much time.
She's too slow. It's not going to burn out.
The darkness will come again.
Thank you.
The beast is crawling into your mind, searching for weakness. It found your mother and used her to trap you in here.
Did you see her die? I don't remember. I was only 5. They told me she escaped the darkness, that she's with the gods. But what if they lied? What if the darkness took her and trapped her here?
Stupid
girl! It's a trap. The beast is coming. Stupid beast.
Run away from the beast!
Now it can see you at your weakest. The time you suffered as a child at the hands of your father Zindo while you pined for Dillion. Do you remember the darkness, Senua? The beast is bringing it back.
Did you leave me? This darkness, it's spreading. Father's keeping me away from the others. Away from Tillian. I won't give up. I'm not going to rot in here. I'm going to find Dillion.
Go.
Rain the Dwarf's sole desire is to possess this dragon's accursed treasure, and he uses Sigurd to reclaim it. He tells Sigurd the story of Fafnir's gold, and the good-hearted hero promises to slay the dragon if Rain would forge a strong sword for him. Sigurd remembers that his father once possessed a sword given to him by Odin. Odin broke the sword to bring about Sigmund's death, but Sigurd's mother still has the pieces. And so Rain reforges the famous sword. Sigurd uses the sword first to avenge his father, and then he and Rain go in search of Fafnir.
She will be trapped.
The beast has the head and he's using it.
Once she gets down there, she'll never come out. It's luring her down.
The darkness will take her like it took her mother.
Deeper and deeper. The beast knows exactly where she is.
She's
falling for it.
She falls for their tricks every time.
Plays into his hands. The lights run out. She'll die.
Fafnir is so large and deadly that it would be impossible to kill him face to face. But each day, Fafnir crawls across the heath to find water. So Sigurd digs a pit in the dragon's path and lies in wait in it. When Fafnir slithers overhead, Sigurd sinks his sword into the dragon up to the hilt. Sigurd leaps from the pit, and Fafnir sees his killer. He warns Sigurd that the treasure will lead to his death, as it led to the death of all who owned it. Sigurd replies that death comes to all men, and every man would want to be wealthy until that day. And he takes the treasure.
What's she doing?
She's lighting a torch.
She's making light. She's making a fire.
She's got light on the other side.
She'll be safe. What's her plan? What's she thinking? Is she going to get there?
Help but think of him. A tender guiding flame in a world so black. The longer it burned, the more she convinced herself that there was nothing beyond its reach. How little separates us from what we fear.
Rian wants to keep Fafnir's gold all for himself. Rian also wants the strength and wisdom of the dragon, so he drinks its blood and asks Sigurd to roast Fafnir's heart for him. Sigurd does so, but when he touches the roasted heart to see if it is done, he burns his finger. Without thinking, he licks his finger and tastes the dragon's blood. In that moment, he understands the language of birds and hears them talk nearby.
Didion.
Thank you.
find.
Thank you.
people think of evil as an unnatural, invisible force, and so invoke the gods for protection. But evil can come from the hand behind the gods. A familiar hand. Cold and cruel.
He tried to fix her with his rituals. Kept her trapped in that hole.
She couldn't say which was worse. The darkness.
Or the monster that her father had become. She couldn't fight them both. And so she left, headed for the one ray of light that shone down on her. If she had stayed, she wouldn't have survived. But maybe Delian would still be alive.
I'm so sorry, my love.
She will save his soul, even if this time she can't save her own.
Forgive me, Senua. I know you have no reason to trust me anymore. But believe this, it was my mission to make you hate. To hate the darkness with a passion so great it would focus your mind on this quest. Oh, Lalta.
Yes,
I dreamed of those slack. All this time, I've wanted to protect you from the truth that would have destroyed you a long time ago. But you have conquered your darkness at every turn. You deserve to see behind the veil of darkness.
Then take me to the mountain.
To trust you.
As deep as we can go.
I won't stand in your way.
She has to trust him.
You will not survive what is in there.
I know.
What else can she do? She doesn't want to tell us. She has nothing. She's come this far. She wants to go. She wants this to be